Hey everybody, it's Eric from Thomas Hills Ranch here. We just had a little storm go through, and I guess it was just today, but today and last night have been quite a hectic day for the goats. Actually, it was a hectic day for me. The goats didn't seem to have a care in the world because they have just decided that they ignore all fencing, whether it be barbed wire with electric added or my electric wire. I walked up and my wife, kid and I got the goats pushed back in, and I tested the wire. 11,500 volts were going through, and both wires. And at first I thought they were going towards green feed. As you can see around us, the everything is greening up very nicely. Then I put them in a new paddock with fresh feed. And that was okay for a while. Then it started raining and they decided they wanted to be in an old paddock that had all the green feed eaten away, but it had some trees in it. So they went up there, and that was today. And that's when I kind of just, I pressed my pause button and I just kind of let them wander. And so they went up, they were up here, they went up in the back of the property, then they jumped the barbed wire with the single electric, and then they moved up here. My concern was that they would go all the way over to one of my neighbors over here or back there. And I don't know the neighbors way behind us. I've not met them yet. I think they just own the property. There's no house there. But anyway, I did talk to my neighbor, tell him what was happening. He didn't have any advice. I actually tried to sell my lead doe to him because she's the culprit who's leading them through the wire. The others seem content where they are. But now I've basically what happened is they were all the way up there, and this was about a half an hour ago. And I just started calling them because I have trained them to my voice. That's the one thing the one thing I have done correctly is they are trained to my voice. And so every time I move them, I do the same call, and I just, with a loud specific voice, I say, "Come on, goats, here you go, here you go." And, just keep repeating that over and over. I did that down here and they were at the top of the hill. They kind of disappeared. I called them. And then I went to get some sweet feed to lure them, and when I came out of the shed, they were at the hill looking for me. And so they knew my voice and they came to my voice, and which I just think that's cool. You hear about shepherds working with their animals, and you read the Bible, says know the sound of my voice. They do come to me. They're not trained like dogs, but they do come. They stayed up there for a while and just stared at me, wondering what the heck I was doing, because I was trying to lead them a strange way. But I walked up to them and showed them that I had a bucket of sweet feed. Fed a couple of them from my hand, which is surprising. First time I did that. In the past, I did not want to train them to sweet feed. I just wanted to save it for emergencies like this where they'd escape and I really need to get them back in. Teddy, stop. And so anyway, this was an emergency, but now I have to redo my plan. They don't respect the wire, at least the two wires. I could increase it to four wires, three wires or four wires, but all that does is increase my workload. The big part of me doing this is the quality of life and the lifestyle. I do not want to work myself to death rotating animals around. I really do want to improve the land, but I just don't want to do that, 24 hours a day or, even 10 hours a day. And there's also other things I want to do. I want to teach, and I can't be a full-time teacher if I have these guys, running loose or have to get moved two and three times a day. Everybody's safe. The goats are all safe. As you can see, they've got some nice green grass here. That'll keep them happy for a while. And tonight I have to come up with a plan. I think one thing I would like to do is make sure this whole section here, like I said before, I've got a wire that goes up along the middle all the way to the back. And so what I could do is take my electric wire, run two, three, or four wires all along the perimeter over here, and just give them 20 acres. And I know a couple that we got some of the does from, they did this with 40 acres, and they had an area like this, and they just opened the gate every day, let them out, and then every evening they'd come back for some sweet feed, and the dogs would come back with them. And so they just, I guess it maintained their property that way, and they were doing quite well with it. So I guess I have to admit failure in my plan, which is not a fun thing to do. I was in tears last night thinking, you know, this is a complete and utter failure. But nobody got hurt. Nobody got killed, to include the goats. And old Teddy, he's doing just fine. And if I haven't, I can't remember if I posted on or not, we did get Let Luna go. The couple that had her before, great family. I texted him, said, hey, she's not working out, even though I had her several months. And they very quickly got back to me and said, no, we'll take her. So yeah, very blessed by that. And when I dropped Luna off, she was extremely happy. And she was just more comfortable with that family than she ever was with me. So I think that was a good situation. And I know they have a couple of dogs just like Luna, meaning the same breed. And so now I'm left with this this guy. And he's a big killer. But he's chained up because he likes to play chase with the goats. Oh, and he's barking at our cat behind me. So it's going to be a long night because our house is up here, so I'll be listening to this all night. Anyway, God bless. Thanks for watching, and keep us in your prayers. Thanks. Bye-bye.